This week, about 50 wealthy and powerful people were arrested on charges related to paying a consultant to falsify college applications. Some paid hundreds of thousands, even millions of dollars to the consultant for the chance to send their children to prestigious schools. This demonstrates that at least for some, the social status that college brings is more important than the increased earning potential. It is also not irrelevant that this comes so soon after a similar scandal involving poor minority children who were also falsifying college applications. But before we get to that, visit my shop, Agitator Coffee and Books, at the URL agitatorbooks.com. And support me on Subscribestar, subscribestar.com/Laurel. In this most recent scandal, wealthy families were using their fortunes to get ahead of others. Some of the activities engaged in by the consultant included paying proctors of the ACT and SAT to correct the student's answers after the exam, sending another person to pose as the student to take the exam, photoshopping the students into athletic competitions and sending those pictures with the applications, and simply bribing admissions officials at the universities. According to NPR, in an article entitled U.S. Charges Dozens of Parents, Coaches in Massive College Admissions Scandal, we're talking about deception and fraud, fake test scores, fake credentials, fake photographs, bribed college officials. Andrew Lelling, U.S. Attorney for the District of Massachusetts, said at a news conference Tuesday in Boston. Lelling said 33 parents paid enormous sums to try to ensure that their children got into universities such as Stanford and Yale, sending money to entities controlled by a California man named William Rick Singer in return for obtaining false records and false scores on important tests such as the SAT and ACT. Singer's clients paid him anywhere between $200,000 and $6.5 million for this service. While a lot less money was involved in another recent scandal involving poorer students, there are similarities. About 3 months ago, it was discovered that at the T.M. Landry College Preparatory School in Louisiana, the director of the school was falsifying background stories, essays, recommendations, and grade reports. The only thing he wasn't falsifying were their test scores, and for that, the students report that their entire education at the school was geared toward doing well on the SAT and the ACT. It is also reported that when he falsified the students' background stories in their college applications, he really played up their race. Most of the students were Black. In an article by NBC News entitled What the T.M. Landry Prep Scandal Reveals About Race, Stereotypes, and Inequality in American Education, college admissions officers often enter the field for the opportunity to make a difference in the lives of students who have been trapped by this inequality, said David Hawkins, Executive Director for Educational Content and Policy at the National Association for College Admission Counseling. Most admissions officers understand very well the education divide in this country, Hawkins said. Then you take that Horatio Alger thing that you got into the field, and then the recognition that many students have a tremendously hard time even getting to the point of application. And yes, many admissions officers are keen to identify those students, those stories, and create those bridges to opportunity. These two scandals together represent hundreds of applications. One can imagine a fraudulent application or two slipping past the admissions officers, but hundreds? Could it be that the admissions officers were easily fooled because they wanted to accept these groups of people? What do these groups have in common? There's the wealthy on the one hand and minorities, especially poor minorities, on the other hand. They're both groups that the left favors. As much as Bernie Sanders may say that he doesn't favor the wealthy, the Democratic Party sure seems to attract a lot of wealthy people. In previous videos, I've discussed how left-leaning the universities have become. Their ideology applies not only to the classrooms, but also the admissions process. But not only do the universities really want these groups of people, these groups of people really want the universities. A college education has become a necessity for an upstanding leftist. They will do anything to get it. As much as the left says they eschew privilege, they have become the greatest peddlers of social standing and have become subservient to it. A university education is essential to social standing on the left. The only reason for a parent to pay $6.5 million to get their child into a prestigious school is for the social standing. There is no way a college education could ever make up that much money in increased earning potential. This scandal is the greatest evidence ever that social standing has become an essential element of our higher education system. The right is no longer using college for social standing to the same extent as the left. According to the Pew Research Center, in an article entitled "College Graduates Continue to Shift Toward the Democratic Party," there is a fabulous graphic showing that over the past 23 years, it has become more common for Democrats to have a higher education than for Republicans, whereas 23 years ago, it was the reverse. Specifically, for college graduates in 1994, 39% of Republicans had a college degree, whereas only 27% of Democrats did. However, now it is 35% of Democrats and 24% of Republicans. And when it comes to postgraduate experience in 1994, the numbers were essentially the same at around 32 or 33%, whereas now 41% of Democrats have postgraduate experience, whereas only 19% of Republicans do. It is true that many on the right are still going. College does actually offer something useful, especially for people who want to enter STEM or want to be doctors or lawyers. For them, the leftist admissions policies can be quite frustrating. I wonder how much of the decline in Republicans attending college is due to conservatives simply opting out of college, and how much is due to discriminatory admissions processes. These recent scandals don't tell us anything we didn't already know about which groups of people the universities favor. What they do tell us is just how badly people on the left want the social status that comes with that little piece of paper. The rest of us should be smart, save our money, shake our heads, and walk away. We will gain our social standing through character and merit. That's all for today.